Back in Isaiah 47 and 10.
Kill!
Thy wisdom and thy knowledge it hath perverted thee. And thou hast said in thine heart, I am and none else beside me.
Right. You thought you was a god.
Right.
You created your own little demigod. You because these people really, all these other nations look at you as a god.
Right.
Yeah. That's why they want to be just like you.
Yep.
Even
right.
Jake is the former of all things. You'll take Jake's idea, give him money for it,
right.
And then Jake start following you.
Right.
Like he forgot he made it. You know?
Yeah.
That's crazy, man. Yeah.
Verse 11. Therefore shall evil come upon thee.
That's why your evil gonna come upon
you,
man.
That's right.
The evil times, man.
Right. Yeah.
Thou shalt not know from whence it riseth.
True.
And mischief shall fall upon thee.
Woo.
Thou shalt not
the
be.
The missiles is mischief,
right.
Man.
Right.
They ain't gonna fall upon you, man. Because all you did was go around and start trouble, man.
That's right.
To and fro.
Right.
Yeah.
Thou shalt not be able to put it off. And desolation shall come upon thee suddenly.
Right, you ain't gonna be able to stop this thing, man.
Right.
Once the Most High push the buffalo, the missiles is done, man.
God.
Right. When the Most High shoot them arrows, you can't say, oh, time out. You can't say, oh, I didn't mean to do that, my bad.
Yeah.
You know, nah. Most High gonna let it follow through.
God.
Yeah.
It says, which thou shalt not know.
Right, which you shall not even know, man.
I got a precept.
Yeah.
You can put a bra on, man.
That would be nice.
That would be an excuse, man.
Yeah. Right. It says, 2 Ezra 16 and 13.
God!
For strong is his right hand.
Hold on, there's more on that, brother. Hey, go up to 14, brother.
Go up to 14.
It's locked in, brother.
It says, verse 12.
God.
Stand now with thine enchantment.
Woo! Stand now with your enchantments, man.
Good.
It says, and with the multitude of thy sorceries.
Yeah, stand side by side with it.
Right.
This is the energy that you use to hold you down.
Right.
Right? Now deal with it now.
Right.
Man, thou hast labored from thy youth.
Right, you've been doing this from the time when you was born.
Yeah.
Speaking lies and mischief, man.
Yeah.
Came out the womb.
Yeah.
If so be thou shalt be able to profit, if so be thou mayest prevail. Verse 13. Thou art wearied in the multitude of thy counsel.
They tired.
Yep.
They worn out.
Yep.
That's why you got dudes, what's his name, Bannon, dropping off the council. He was a council. The sorcerers, they worn out.
Now,
they keep waking up, Trump.
Because what was going on is that with sorcery, you gotta keep on sacrificing,
right.
Doing things.
Right.
You gotta all, because Satan make you work.
Right.
Like that dude was saying in the video.
Right.
He said Satan makes you work, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
You don't have no rest in him.
Right.
He said, yo, if I didn't follow what he wanted me to do, he'll kill somebody.
Right.
He said one time he made him blind.
Yeah, a whole year.
For a whole year.
Yeah.
Wow.
They tired. They don't know what to do with themselves. Brothers keep waking up. They keep prophesying.
Because that's witchcraft. That whole a homosexual vibration is
right.
People that put spirits out there.
Because
he said, I put spirits of death out there.
Yeah.
I put demons out there to wear the people out,
yeah,
man.
Yeah.
Yeah, brother, keep reading.
It says, let know the astrologers.
Right.
The stargazers.
Does this place not have astrologers?
Yeah.
Where they get a 7-week day forecast?
Yeah.
How is that possible? That means that they staring at the stars and they predicting something to happen.
They studying all day.
Right.
They study because they looking for something.
That's right.
You know? And even they get it wrong. The Most High jacked them up. They say, oh, it's going to rain at
right.
6 o'clock and it don't rain.
Right.
They said the forecast yesterday, today, all day is supposed to rain.
Yeah. It's
sunny out.
And the Lord be switching it up on them, man.
God.
Yeah. Like, and the Lord make it snow. Just to make them be liars, man. You know? Yeah.
They blame it on warming, man.
Yeah, they predicting 2050.
The Most High.
The Most High definitely gonna make him a liar.
It says the monthly prognosticators.
Monthly. Them dudes that. Yeah, that's what they do, man.
Damn.
You know, and that's why a lot of them. Eve loved going into horoscopes.
What's
your sign? Virgo.
Oh, you a Libra? That
what's your Libra?
Is.
What the hell does that mean? You still gonna be a thot?
Right.
You still a thot?
Yeah, you just a Leo thot.
You know?
That sign never changed.
Exactly. You get mad when you say
that time has changed. That thot is on every side.
Yeah, how about that horoscope?
With the legs open.
And what's this sign?
You a holler. I'm a holler. I'm a holler.
I'm a thot. Every day I never change.
Yeah.
Yeah. Says. The Stargazers, the monthly prognosticator.
The Stargazers.
She ain't even worried about you, man.
Yeah.
They about to gaze at the stars right now.
So stand up and save thee from these things that shall come upon thee.
Yeah, can Jettis and Jabberies?
Wow.
Can they save you when the time comes?
Wow.
The Stargazers? Because they get their energy off what the stars do. And the Most High said the stars serve us. The moon serve us.
Right.
You know?
That's right.
Says, verse 14, behold, they shall be as stubble.
Stubble.
The fire shall burn them.
Woo. So all them witches that y'all set up, they all gonna be destroyed, man.
That's right.
Yeah.
Says, they shall not deliver themselves from the power of the flame.
They can't deliver themselves from the power of the flame. That's why when you watch that movie, the Ten Commandments, yo, Pharaoh was going back to the sorcerers, he's like, yo, what should we do? They didn't even know what the hell to do.
I don't know.
That dude was holding his son died, they was like, yo, can't do nothing, you know? Yeah.
There shall not be a coal to warm at, nor fire to sit before it.
Oh,
right.
That's it. 50? That's 50.
That's good. What you got? Yeah.
This is
Judith.
You got
some? Get it.
Numbers chapter 23, verse 7.
Good.
It says, and he took up his parable and said, but Lot, the king of Moab, have brought me for a rum out of the mountains of the east, saying, come, curse me, Jacob, come, defy Israel. Right, so they had warlocks in the ancient world that tried to curse us.
And that was the one, the king of Moab.
King of Moab.
Yeah, you know, them Asian people, a lot of them Asians, man, they hate Israel, man.
Right.
You know, hurry up and buy it. They mad disrespectful to you, man.
Yeah. Verse 9. For from the top of the rocks I see him. So they went on a high top to look down at us.
Con.
The same way that they look from their satellites to look down on us. That's all they doing. It says, from the top of the hills I behold him. Lo, the people shall dwell alone and shall not be reckoned among the nations. Verse 10. Who can count the dust of Jacob?
Yo, you got twin brother?
Yeah, he just walked by. Yeah.
Oh, that's crazy, man.
Yeah.
In the number of the fourth part of Israel, let me die the death of righteous and let my last end be like this. So, hey, even though he tried to curse us, there was spirits that was telling, that showed them a prophecy about our last end. That our last end, we're gonna be raised up and we're gonna be living in a righteous kingdom. To the point where he was like, shoot, man, I wish I could be like them.
That's right.
You know? But that was the point.
Yeah, brother.
This is Judas chapter 5, verse 1.
God!
Then was it declared to the
Holofernes.
Holofernes, the chief captain of the army of Assur.
Now what's going on is King Nebuchadnezzar, he had a top general named Holofernes, and he was going to war with another king. And what happened was Nebuchadnezzar sent out letters to the other nations to help him out. They said, no, we're not helping him out, right? So what he did was, he said, listen, if I win this battle against this dude, I'm gonna come back and get at all y'all guys. So this guy, Holofernes, he was Nebuchadnezzar's top general, man. Okay? So now he wanna come at Israel,
right.
And Israel ain't going for it, man.
Right.
But watch what happens, man. Go ahead.
That the children of Israel had prepared for war and had shut up the passages of the hill country.
Right, so they fortified and fortified themselves around so they can't be attacked by Holofernes and the Assyrians, man.
Right.
Yeah.
fortified all the tops of the high hills.
Yeah.
And had laid impediments in the campaign's countries.
Right, they put up roadblocks, man.
Come.
Yeah.
Verse 2. Wherewith he was very angry and called all the princes of Moab.
Yo, my man, why don't you take them blood beads off, man?
Yo.
Yeah, why don't you take them blood beads off,
why don't you
man?
Take that off, bro? What's, right. that, what's that doing?
Because all that's going to do is get you put in jail or get killed, man.
Right.
Okay? Yeah. That's Jake, man. Our people love to be aligned with wickedness, man.
Right.
They love to be Bloods and Crips. They love to be MS-13. They love to be a Latin Kings.
Right.
Zopan, Trinitarians, right. man. Okay? And you ain't going to get nothing out of that but death, man.
Good.
Or jail.
That's right.
Yeah. Chinese.
Right.
All right. That was their ancient name before they called themselves Chinese.
Right.
When you read the Bible, okay? All right. You look up the word Ammon, that's the so-called Japanese, man. When you look up the Bible. Go ahead.
And all the governors of the sea coast.
Yeah.
Verse 3. And he said unto them, tell me now, ye sons of Canaan, who this people is.
So he wanted to know, who is these people that going up in the mountains and defile me and say, yo, they not submitting to us.
God.
Yeah.
That dwelleth in the hills country.
Uh-huh.
And what are the cities that they inhabit?
Right, what's the city that they occupy?
God.
So he wanted information on the Israelites.
That's right.
Yeah.
And what is the multitude of their armies?
Right.
What is the multitude? Where their strength come from?
That's right.
What is their power? How are they able to function like this? Yeah.
And wherein is their power and strength?
Where do they get their power from?
That's right.
Who's their general?
That's right.
Okay, go ahead.
And what king is set over them, or captain of their army?
Right.
Verse 4. And why have they determined not to come to meet me?
Right, because they knew. That's why you gotta go into the history books. You gotta learn about Nebuchadnezzar.
Right.
You gotta learn about the different the kings, the wars.
Right.
The different wars that transpired, the Punic Wars.
That's right.
Stuff like that that goes into that happened.
Right.
Because then you understand how did we come here on slave ships, man.
Right.
Yeah, if you got a question, you gotta ask the speakers, brother. Alright?
Alright.
Alright? Give me 1 minute, let me just finish my point, I got you. Yeah.
And why have they determined not to come meet me more than all the inhabitants of the West?
Right, because all the West was cooling out.
Right.
But Israel always had that spirit where, yo, we not with that.
Right, brother.
Yeah.
Then said Achior, the captain of all the sons of Ammon.
Right, Achior was a damn a Japanese dude, man.
Right.
Okay, go ahead.
Let my lord now hear a word from the mouth of thy servant, and I will declare unto thee the truth concerning this people, which dwelleth near thee.
Right, you about to give him the history.
Right, so he gonna break down the history on who the Israelites are. Just like all you people, y'all should know who the real Israelites are.
Right.
Because they lied to y'all people. Y'all don't understand that the people that came on them slave boats are the sons of God.
That's right.
Okay? Yeah.
And inhabiteth the hills country. And there shall no lie come out of the mouth of thy servant.
Yeah.
No lie.
This people were descendants of the Chaldees.
Right.
And they sojourned heretofore Mesopotamia because they would not follow.
During the time of Genesis.
That
was Abraham's family, his father. That's where he was living at.
Good, that's a stupid.
God, what's your question, bro?
That's a stupid.
Where are you guys?
Yeah, we Israelites.
Yeah. I just watched a documentary on you guys last night.
Yeah, well, what documentary was that?
The Vice documentary.
Nah, that's not, them dudes are not Israelites. Those not Israelites, man. We don't get down with guns and all that stuff. That's not us, man.
Okay.
All right, those not the real Israelites.
All right.
You talking about the Vice documentary that ISUPK and them did, man. You're not with them guys, man.
Okay.
Yeah.
I was wondering.
It's cool.
And says, which were in the land of the Chaldees, for they left the way of their ancestors and worshiped the God of heaven.
Right, they left the way of their ancestors. and they started worshiping the gods of heaven.
That's right.
Meaning what? The other nations.
Right.
Because all when you look at history, you look at all the other nations, the Egyptians, the Roman Empire, the Babylonian, the Medo-Persian Empire.
Right.
They all worship other deities. They all worship objects.
Right.
All
right?
And anytime that we worship objects, we got in trouble for it.
Right.
Okay? Go ahead.
The God. So they cast them out from the face of their gods.
That's right.
Yeah.
And they fled into Mesopotamia and sojourned there many days.
Yeah.
Then their God commanded them to depart from the place where they sojourned.
Uh-huh.
And to go into the land of Canaan.
Right, which is Israel. Okay? That's how we occupied Israel. The real Israelites looked like myself and other brothers in different shades, man. All right?
Yeah.
Where they dwelt and were increased with gold and silver and with much cattle.
Yeah, right.
But when the famine covered all the land of Canaan, they went down into Egypt.
Joseph.
Yeah, that's how Yaakov, that's happened with Joseph.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
And sojourned there while they were nourished and became
right.
There a great multitude.
God,
so that one could not number their nation.
Right, so that's what happened when they went to Egypt.
God.
And that's when the other Pharaoh came into power.
Yeah.
He didn't know Joseph and them.
Yeah.
Ramses, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. God.
Therefore the king of Egypt rose up against them and dwelt subtlety with them and brought them low with laboring and brick.
That's when you see the pyramids.
Right.
But we the ones that built the pyramids. All right, so they already know our history.
Right.
They got all the legends. Every time a slave got sold,
that's right.
They knew exactly who they were selling.
That's right.
Okay? The people that came over in cargo slave ship were the Israelites.
That's
man.
Right.
All
right,
and we were scattered, like the prophecy tell you in James 1 and 1,
mm-hmm.
that we were gonna be scattered abroad.
Yeah.
That's why we got brung to the West Indies. We got brung to Brazil.
That's right.
We got brung all over, man. Okay? Yeah.
It says, and brought them low, laboring in bricks, and made them slaves.
That's right. Why, that's why you see the people that left out of Egypt. If you go to Belize, you'll see pyramids there.
Right.
Why? Because those are the same people that do the science of making pyramids in Egypt.
That's right.
That's why you go to Mexico, you see the Israelites built pyramids in Mexico. Because we were the same ones that built pyramids in Egypt.
That's right.
That's why you go to Brazil, you see pyramids in Brazil.
That's right.
Okay? Yeah.
Hey, and to make the comparison also to America, when you come to America and you go to these construction sites, you see nothing but
so-called Mexicans.
So-called Mexicans, sometimes Jack, because they know how to do that work.
Hey, who helped build the Empire State? When you do the research, they actually had to contact the tribe of Gad, what they call Native American Indians, because they was trying to figure out how the hell they could build buildings in the air. Because when you go to places in Mexico, they got buildings in the sky.
God.
You know?
Yes.
Verse 12. Then they cried unto their God, and he smote all the land of Egypt with an incurable plague.
That's why you see what happened, the whole Red Sea and the plagues.
God.
So this Moabite, this Ammonite, he knew all the history on us, man.
Right.
Just like these elites, they know exactly who we are.
Right.